applications of Java programming. It is a technical term, or in public term, you can say uses of Java. Uses of Java. See, Java is used to develop desktop applications. Desktop applications. It's nice from your side, Akila. Try to avoid. Saurav.
Yes, sir.
Okay, background noise. Java is used to develop desktop GUI applications. Next, web applications, websites. Oh, web applications. Desktop GUI applications, Akila. For example, Acrobat Radar is there. That is one-tier application, standalone application, desktop application developed in Java technology. Web applications, websites. Next, enterprise applications. Enterprise applications. What are enterprise applications? Akila, identify what are enterprise applications in our IT industry. Enterprise applications means
I don't know, sir.
You don't know enterprise applications. Suppose banking is one enterprise, na? Banking is enterprise, insurance is enterprise, ERP, e-commerce, logistics, all are enterprises, na?
Yes, sir.
Say ERP. Actually, for ERP development, we have separate software packages like SAP, Microsoft Web Dynamics, Oracle apps, etc. packages. We can customize, developers can customize those packages. But we can, not we, developers, Java developers can write ERP applications. If we use SAP, SAP, then it is easy to customize the ERP system. If you use Java, you need to write the code from scratch. But ERP applications can be developed using Java technology or .NET technology or ERP packages, like using ERP packages like SAP, etc. ERP. Next, banking. Banking. Next, insurance. Next, healthcare. Next, nowadays trending, e-commerce, etc. Okay, Nastaro?
Yes.
Next, scientific applications. Scientific applications. Next, mobile applications. Mobile applications. Suppose Android, mobile operating system. Android developed in Java technology. See, we have separate edition, software edition in Java for supporting mobile like small devices. JME, Java Micro Edition. Okay, mobile applications. Next, embedded systems. Do you have any idea about this embedded systems, Akila? What are embedded systems? Saurav, what are embedded systems? You heard this term?
I hear it, sir. I think, is this one used in like toys
or
robots?
Okay.
Machine.
Okay. Say, embedded systems means hardware device related applications. Say, software components insert into devices, physical devices means mechanical device, mechanical device or electronic device. See, device related applications. Actually, Java was first developed for washing machines, writing chip program for washing machines and telephone set-top boxes. That time in 1990s, set-top box technology was very advanced. Later, they used for different domains. Embedded systems, software components insert into hardware devices, not hardware here, hardware okay. Software components insert into devices, mechanical devices or electronic devices. Suppose washing machine, fridge, telephone set-top box. Pardon? Just a minute. Lift. Lift is mechanical device. Telephone coin box, etc. All these are embedded systems. In banking also, ATM software is there. ATM software is embedded system. Online banking system is general software. Core banking system is general software. ATM banking system is embedded software. Sauro, why that software operates the ATM machine? Na?
Yes.
Now you tell me, Akila, DVD?
DVD player also has the chip, sir.
What chip?
It is also an embedded system.
DVD
player.
What program embedded into that DVD player?
The Java program.
Java program. See.
What program? Chip.
Actually, DVD systems are not pure embedded systems. See, DVD, electronic device. For operating the DVD, we may have DVD drivers. Driver is software, but that is not pure operating system. Pure embedded system. Pure embedded system means ATM, next lift program, set-top box program, washing machine program, etc. DVD is not a pure embedded system. Okay. DVD generally electronic device. They may have electronic chips, but drivers, software drivers required to operate the DVD. For printers also, printers, scanners, etc. also software drivers required, but they are not pure embedded systems. Next. Big data technologies. Big data technologies. Next. Distributed applications. Distributed applications. What are distributed applications, Saurav? Nowadays, most of the applications are distributed applications. Say 10 years back, 20 years back, 80 to 90% applications were independent applications. Now distributed applications. What are distributed applications? For example, online banking, internet banking application is there, that is distributed application. Internet banking system interacts with ATM software. Suppose if you transfer money from your internet application, that can be reflected in ATM software and core banking server. Next, if you pay bills, your telephone bills, then it will communicate with the telecom server. If you pay credit card bills, it will communicate with the credit card management system, etc. Nowadays, all are business distributed applications. Getting the point?
Yes.
Distributed applications. Next, cloud. Cloud-based applications. You know about this one, cloud-based applications, Akila, cloud applications.
Netflix, sir.
Pardon?
Netflix, it moved to cloud.
I'm not asking about example. Cloud, what is cloud? Cloud servers. For example, Gmail is cloud. Google Drive is there na? Google Drive is cloud. Say WAN servers, wide area network. Suppose if you use LAN, LAN technology, you need to maintain your physical servers. If it is WAN technology, they maintain servers in wide area network. Suppose Gmail is that cloud application. Google Drive cloud application. See, nowadays most of the OTT platforms also cloud applications, cloud servers. Getting?
Yes.
Next, web servers and application servers. Web servers and application servers. Say, we are going to test web applications, Saurav, using Selenium. We need to familiar with web technologies, at least. Say, actually, to learn and use Selenium, some HTML basics required. Not only HTML basics, web environment basics required. Why? We are going to conduct web application testing using Selenium. So, some web environment basics required. That is prerequisites to learn and use Selenium. Okay. Web servers and application servers. These can be used in enterprise web application development. Say web servers for small size website applications also. Application servers for enterprise applications. Can you give two or three examples for web servers and application servers, Akila? Give examples for web servers. What is the purpose of web server? That we will discuss later. Anyhow, that is not our syllabus. Give one or two examples for web servers and application servers. These technologies can be used in web development. You need to familiar with what is HTML, what is XML, what is CSS, what is web server, what is application server, what is database server. You need to familiar with these web technologies. Tell me, give one or two examples for web server, Saurav.
Sorry, Apache.
Apache, good. Apache web server, open source. Suppose Microsoft web server is there. If you install Windows, that web server will be installed automatically. IIS. Do you hate this term, IIS?
Yes, sir.
And earlier it was Internet Information Service, now Internet Information Server. This web server is used for .NET applications. IIS, Apache web server, Java web server, next Pramati web server, etc. Application servers. Give one or two examples for application servers, Akila. Application servers. Akila, application servers. Do you hate this term, application servers?
No, sir.
Okay, web logic is there na? Do you hate this one? Web logic.
Yeah, web logic.
Web logic, WebSphere, these are application servers. Okay, say our Java can be used for developing web servers and application servers. Next, software tools. Software tools. Observe this point, Saurav. Software tools. For example, Selenium is there. Core Selenium developed using Java technology. Java technology. JMeter is there. JMeter was developed using Java technology. Suppose if you want to run JMeter software in your computer, first you need to install Java. Java runtime is required to operate JMeter software. Why? JMeter was developed in Java technology. JMeter is pure Java application. So Java required. Suppose if you want to use SOAP UI for web services testing, for running SOAP UI also Java installation required. JMeter developed in Java, Selenium developed in Java, SOAP UI developed in Java. Next, UFT, formerly QTP, UFT developed in .NET technology, VC++ .NET. Getting this point or any confusion, Saurav?
No confusion, sir.
Software tools. Next, games. See, game testing also is there. Game applications. Game applications. Next, smart cars. Etc. Smart. This is the primary purpose of Java. Primary purpose of Java is software development.